Hey guys, I'm Craig with Rife, and today we're going to introduce you to the Mamba Pole Spear. These pole spears consist of carbon and fiberglass. They're heavier on the carbon side, so that gives us the lightness and strength of the carbon, but also the durability of fiberglass. These Mamba Pole Spears come in three different sizes. We have a 2-piece 6, a 2-piece 8, and a 3-piece 9. Let's go inside and we'll go over some details. Our hardened CNC machine stainless steel connections are precision made here in San Clemente. This allows us to keep an eye on the tolerances in production and ensure that we are creating a quality part to put out to you guys. The 6-foot Mamba package comes with a 36-inch front section, a 36-inch back section, and an 18-inch by 5/16 diameter 24-thread Hawaiian flopper shaft. The band is a 36-inch in length by 1/2 inch diameter band. This package can be sold as is or with our 42-inch slinger pole spear bag. The Mamba 8-foot package comes with a 4-foot front piece, a 4-foot back piece, an 18-inch injector rod, a slip tip retainer bungee, the slip tip itself rigged with Spectra, and a 50-inch by 1/2 inch diameter band. The 8-foot Mamba package comes as is or with our 54-inch slinger pole spear case. The 9-foot Mamba package comes with a front 36-inch section, a middle 36-inch section, and a back 36-inch section. It also comes with a 18-inch injector rod, a slip tip retainer bungee, the slip tip itself rigged in Spectra, and a 58-inch by 1/2 inch diameter band. The kit comes as is like this, or with our 42-inch slinger bag pole spear case. Here's a quick demonstration on setting up the Rife Mamba slip tip system. First, we'll take our slip tip retainer bungee, thread it through the loop on the grip assembly. That's nice and snug there. Then we will thread in our injector rod. This is a 5/16 diameter injector rod with 24 thread. Then we'll take our loop here on the slip tip and we'll pass it through the stainless steel loop on the slip tip retainer bungee, up through the cable nose loop, and then up over the injector rod. Pull that down nice and snug. And then we place the slip tip up on the injector rod, and everything's snug and ready to go.